Well, the Sacramento Kings have a brand new announcer. This is a pretty big deal, people.
Yes.
Cody standing by with more.
It's a huge deal. We got this brand new person going to be on the Kings broadcast. Brand new. Would you like to meet this person?
Yeah. Would love. Oh, hold
Shall
on.
Shall we stretch here before
But you got to wait, though. You got to wait to meet this person.
We're just building the excitement. Hey, Katie, start your video. Press the button. Press the camera button.
Okay, oh, wait. Hold on, let's run back. Okay.
It's a big deal, ladies
and
gentlemen.
It's a big
deal. Katie, so good. I'm so happy for you. This is amazing.
I am super excited, and thanks for having me on. And yes, you don't want the video on until you tell me the video is on. There's dogs and kids and all craziness going on.
It's kind of like here.
Katie, I don't mean to say that I did this, but on my computer here, I did tweet out on August 4th when they announced that Doug Christie was going to be, you know, going to the coaching staff. I tweeted out, now that Doug Christie is joining the coaching staff, would love to see Katie join Mark Jones on the broadcast, and boom, it has manifested.
I can thank you for that. You dreamed it into reality for me, Cody.
So what does this mean? I mean, this is not just personally, but this is huge news.
Yeah, you know, it's crazy because I honestly don't think that it's set in yet. It's kind of been a crazy week, and I've had family in town and a kid's birthday and the job announcement. And I think that once kind of training camp starts and I'm kind of in action, it's going to settle in. But for me, this is something that I've always wanted. And as you know, there's 30 of these jobs in the NBA. And to be one of them that has the possibility of calling these games and being in that booth alongside Mark Jones and Kyle Draper when he's on the call is an honor, but it's then to step further. And, you know, there's one other woman in the league that does this job full time. And then there's that's Sarah Cusack in Brooklyn. And then there's Annie Myers-Drysdale that calls half the games in Phoenix. So that takes it to a whole nother level to me. And it's just kind of surreal. But this is a dream job for me. And I'm just super excited for the season to start at this point.
Oh, I am stoked, too. I think the team's going to be better this year. We're going to play some defense. It's going to be great. Now, I've always been amazed by your talent of being able to talk. Like, you will talk for like 4 minutes explaining something highly complicated with a billion people screaming in your ears and cowbells and stuff like that, and you never mess up. I can't even do that when it's quiet in the studio. How do you do it?
You know, I think part of that honestly is playing. You know, you get so used to when you're playing of you tune everything out around you. You don't hear the crowd, you don't hear people, you're just so focused on that moment. So I think that helps a lot. But yeah, this is a lot different. This is a lot different job. You know, before I'm kind of, you know, in the studio and on the sidelines and being on the game call, I think the most exciting part about it is that I get to let the game speak for itself. And for me, it's kind of like an extensive film study. I love to just, you know, Doug Christie is so excited and he's up and he's all over the place, can't sit down. And I'm like this while I'm watching the game. I'm just back and forth. So I'm excited. It's a new challenge. And, you know, for the Kings to give me this opportunity and for the immense support around the community, I really can say this. I've worked in other markets. Sacramento is a really, really special place. And from day one, I got here 15 years ago. The amount of support from the fans has been, you know, incredible. I can't even put it into words. So I'm really excited. And I want to thank everybody. I haven't even really been on social media at this point. It's just been kind of a crazy week. And as you can tell, I'm a little under the weather. I've been sick. That's what kids in school do to you now that they're back in school. But I haven't even gone on social media to thank everyone. All of the messages, everything. It's so touching. I'm so grateful and thank you. I'm so excited.
Now, I want to make sure that you're ready for the season. So I found some video. Now, I couldn't afford some good Kings video. So I found some video of 1950s. It's a New York Knickerbockers taking on Fort Wayne, Indiana. So we're going to play a little bit of this video.
Oh, my goodness.
And if you could give us some color commentary. Okay, you ready?
Okay.
Okay.
I'm going to take this very seriously,
right.
Cody.
Here we go. Here we go. Look at them. They're flying down.
Look at this high-flying action.
Flying up the court. They're wearing flip-flops on the court. Of course, this court has terrible, terrible, you know, surface on it. Look at that. The immense athletic ability. They got 2 inches off the ground. Look at that. Oh, my goodness. The pure athletic ability. Look at these athletes.
Oh, my God. What was that?
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
What was that?
It's kind of amazing how the game has evolved, right?
I love the way the guy shot the free throw like that.
Wait, those are professionals?
They used to do the granny shot, too, so...
Oh,
yeah.
Fantastic. You're ready. Now, Katie, you know, I adore you. I think you're absolutely the cat's meow. I think you're just the coolest person ever. But you're also the best dressed person on television. And I say that. I sit next to Courtney every day. She's amazingly dressed. But I've always had a dream. I've always wanted to see your closet.
Ooh.
Now, we're going to give you the opportunity. You can say no. But we have another segment that's open after the break. Is there any way you could take me to the closet to show me?
I am in the middle of absolute chaos in my closet right now. I will take you up on it another time, but I have to give a shout out. I don't know, Stephanie Cumberland of Presenting You.
I love that.
Yes. She has built my wardrobe. I started working with her 15 years ago when I came to Sacramento. I didn't even know how to do my makeup at the time. She taught me how to do my makeup, got my hair, everything. She has built my wardrobe. I wouldn't have that honor of Cody thinking I had such an amazing wardrobe if it wasn't without Stephanie Cumberland. Okay. So I have to give that shout out to her.
I will take that rain check. One day I get to see your closet. Because you seriously.
One day,
you
I'll make
have
it
the
beautiful
most amazing
for you,
wardrobe.
Cody.
Okay, all right. Katie, thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations. I'm so excited for you. I think this is such a neat opportunity. And she has worked her tail off to get to this place.
Right?
I'm telling you, it's so amazing. Thank you, Katie.